Now, what are these 10 great subjects? And to be able to see them, let me bring this up to date. When I wrote this, I was traveling by train. And train travel was more popular then than plane travel. And I used the Union Station of a railroad. And now you could use the airport or air terminal for the airlines. Let me bring it up to date then. Let's go out to the International Airport here in Los Angeles. And you could do that in any of the great airports across the country. Here comes in a plane. It comes all the way from Japan. The people there are Japanese. Maybe if you didn't know or had never seen a Japanese, you'd be interested in taking a good look at them. And you'd say, my, wonder where they came from. And you'd notice that many of them were wearing a different garb than we wear. And you would have quite a few questions you'd want to know about. And you'd need to know where they came from to understand that airplane unloading and the people getting out. Now, here comes an airplane out of New York City. It's filled with businessmen. And they're all dressed up, and they hit the pavement running with a briefcase after more business. Well, you've got to understand where they came from. And then here comes one in from Houston, Texas. They're all oil men, all very rich. Each one carrying him a gallon of oil, make sure he makes it through the day. Well, you need to know where they've come from. And then here comes a plane out of South America. And again, they're speaking a tongue you don't understand, but you need to know where it's come from. Now, the book of Revelation is an airport, and there are 10 great airlines that come in to this airport. And you need to understand where it began and how it was developed as it comes into the book of Revelation. That's important for us to know. Now, let me just mention these, and I'll be taking them up as we come to them. The Lord Jesus Christ is number one. Now, I'm not going to develop that today, but he's the subject of the book, not the beast. But the sin bearer, the Lord Jesus, he's the subject of this book. Don't get your eyes off of him on bowls of wrath, because you'll miss the book if you do. Now, we begin with him way back in Genesis 3:15, the seed of the woman. And then number two is the church. And you find that where the church begins, not in the Old Testament. The Lord Jesus mentioned it the first time in Matthew 16:18 when he said, on this rock I will build my church. And then you have the resurrection and translation of the saints. That's the third great subject. And that's over in John 14, 1 Thessalonians 4:13 and 18, 1 Corinthians 15:51 to 52, and there are other passages, and I'll be referring to that when we get to it. Now, the fourth is the Great Tribulation. Began way back in Deuteronomy, the fourth chapter, when God said that his people would be in tribulation. And then, Satan and evil. Where did he begin? Well, we have that back in Ezekiel, the 28th chapter. I'll deal with that when we get to it. Then the sixth is the man of sin. And again, back in the 28th chapter of Ezekiel. Then you have the seventh, the course and end of apostate Christendom. And you have that given to us in Matthew 13. And Daniel had something to say about this world condition. And then we see the end of it here. Then the eighth great trunk line of prophecy, the airplane of prophecy that's coming into the airport here, is the beginning, the course and end of the times of the Gentiles. Lord Jesus said Jerusalem would be trodden down of the Gentiles till the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled. And then the ninth great airplane of prophecy is the second coming of Christ. And we have that given here in a great deal of detail. And then number 10, Israel's covenants, beginning with the covenant God made with Abraham back in the 12th chapter of Genesis and five things that God promised Israel, and God says here he's going to make all of them good, and just as he'll make the promise that he's made for us. Now, friends, again, we've spent the entire time on the great theme of an introduction, and that's important for this book. I trust that you'll see the importance of that as we get into the text of it, and I promise you next time we're going to get our foot in the door of this book, because, very frankly, I just can't wait to get in this book. It's a great one, but it does need to be handled properly today, and I trust that we'll be able to do that. You pray for us. We need the Spirit of God to guide us, especially in this book, because this is the revelation of Jesus Christ, and it's only the Spirit of God, as the Lord Jesus said, he'll take the things of mine and show them unto us. Now, I want to mention this. In our notes and outlines we send out, we have a little chart. It's a very simple chart, and it's in our book on Revelation, and it's in our book, Briefing the Bible. I consider this very important. Begins with the cross of Christ and his ascension. And in chapter 1, we see the glorified Christ here in Revelation. In chapters 2 and 3, we see the church. And in chapters 4 and 5, the church is in heaven. And then there takes place on the earth the great tribulation period, chapters 6 through 18. Chapter 19, he comes to earth again. And he establishes kingdom, and you have in the 20th chapter of Revelation the thousand-year reign of Christ. Then the great white throne is set up, and there's where the lost are judged, and then eternity begins. That's the book of Revelation. Now, is that the way that it's given to us? That is very important, by the way. And John wrote this book on the Isle of Patmos approximately around 96 A.D. or 95, somewhere in that time. It was when Domitian was on the throne. But Stauffer puts it like this. He says Domitian was also the first emperor to wage a proper campaign against Christ, and the church answered the attack under the leadership of Christ's last apostle, John of the Apocalypse. Nero had Paul and Peter destroyed, but he looked upon them as seditious Jews. Domitian was the first emperor to understand that behind the Christian movement there stood an enigmatic figure who threatened the glory of the empress. He was the first to declare war on this figure, and the first also to lose the war, a foretaste of things to come.